Today we're going to be taking a look at the Ryobi P343B 18 volt brushed multi-tool, so let's get started. Starting off at the rear of the tool, we have the 18 volt battery slot, which will accept any of Ryobi's 18 volt batteries. Moving forward, we have the hand grip, which has a nice soft rubberized texture. Next, we have the lock-on switch. In order to keep the motor running when not holding the trigger, you will simply need to pull the trigger and then push the switch in, and it will keep the trigger in the on position. And below the lock-on switch, we have the simple trigger. It's basically just an on and off trigger with no variable speeds. And in front of the trigger, we have the power selection slash safety lockout dial. The power selection dial has 6 different power settings on it, and 0. 0 is the lockout safety feature, and when the tool is set to 0, the tool will not operate, although the LED light will turn on. Once you turn the dial to number 1, it'll begin to operate on its lowest power setting. And then you can gradually increase your dial to whatever speed you need to, all the way up to 6, which is the highest power setting. The power setting dial does not have any hard stops or clicks in between the different numbers, except for in between 0 and 1. I personally would have preferred to have clicks in between each different number, but that's my own personal preference. It is possible to change the power selection dial using just the one hand that you're using to hold the tool, and you can change the different speeds while the tool is in operation. However, if you do go to 0, it will turn the tool off and you will have to release the trigger in order to start the tool up again. And at the front of the tool, we have the blade attachment point as well as the blade. The blade is attached to the tool via an Allen bolt, and you will simply use an Allen wrench to secure or tighten into place, much like you would do on a circular saw. It would have been nice if this had been a quick change system, but I can understand at this price point not having that feature. And Ryobi's strategy of storing the Allen key to change the multi-tool blade on the tool itself is always a very useful and always a nice feature, and one I think some other manufacturers would do well to learn from. But personally, I would have preferred a quick release system of some kind, like on Makita or on the DeWalt. But it's still not a deal breaker, and it's still fairly quick and easy to change the blades on this multi-tool. And of course, you can change the angle of the blade depending on what your current cutting situation requires. And last but not least, as I showed in the video, we have the Allen key storage on the rear of the tool near the battery slot. The tool will weigh around 1,510 grams using a 4 amp hour battery as well as the cutting blade. And without a cutting blade or battery, the tool will weigh around 771 grams. Now, comparing my Makita multi-tool to my Ryobi multi-tool, I'd have to say that I've been using the Ryobi way more often than I've been using my Makita. Now, the Makita is definitely the better built tool here, and it has a quick change system for the blades, which makes it super useful and convenient. Unfortunately, the Makita has a very substantial diameter to it, and it's heavier, meaning that it's hard to hold on to, and if you're working in high places or tight areas, you're always worried about dropping it because of the weight. Now, the Ryobi has a smaller hand grip, meaning that it's easier to hold on to for somebody like me with smaller hands, and it has a trigger, which means that you can be more precise, and you can turn off instantly if you just so choose to, meaning you can be more precise in your work. Unfortunately, the Ryobi does not have the quick change blade system that the Makita has, which is definitely a downside. However, it does have an LED light, which the Makita does not. So overall, each tool has its pros and cons, but for me personally, the ease of use of the Ryobi and the fact that I can be more precise with it means that I end up using it more often than the Makita. So I think the Ryobi overall wins this particular competition simply because of ease of use. And that is it for the general overview of the tool. So here are some videos of the tool in action. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about this multi-tool a little bit. Overall, my initial expectations for this multi-tool were not very favorable because of how lightweight it was. But my initial expectations were definitely wrong. It's been able to handle everything that I've thrown at it, and I think it's actually done a little bit better job than the Makita. I think the oscillation width on this multi-tool is actually a little bit wider, meaning that the blade, well, travels a little bit more, so it does a good job of getting more teeth onto the project and going back and forth, meaning that you'll dull your teeth less in a particular area. So I think the multi-tool is doing a fantastic job. Overall, I think the Makita still handles vibration better than this multi-tool does, however. The Makita's heavier mass will absorb the vibrations a little bit more than what this Ryobi and its lighter weight mass can handle. So for vibration control, definitely the Makita. If you're going to use the Ryobi for an extended period of time, I would definitely recommend using some nice vibration absorbing gloves or some heavy gloves, simply because, well, quite frankly, after you use a multi-tool for a long period of time, your arm feels like it's about to vibrate off. So that's just something to keep in mind with this multi-tool. Now, this multi-tool did do a good job of cutting through just about all the materials that I personally threw at it for my projects. Now, I don't do anything with drywall, but I'm sure it's able to cut through drywall as well as any other multi-tool. Drywall's not really that hard to cut through. But for the things I did have to cut through, which was PVC, boards, and the occasional nail, this multi-tool did a great job. It was able to cut through 2x4s and pretty much any board smaller than that just fine. It does take a little bit longer than, well, pretty much any other cutting tool, but it does get the job done and it does a good job. And you can actually be pretty precise with a multi-tool with some practice. Now, the one area that I still don't like using multi-tools with is cutting nails. I just don't like using multi-tools to cut nails. I think that it destroys the blades too quickly, even if it's a good quality blade. And quite frankly, a reciprocating saw or a jigsaw with a metal cutting blade or a demolition blade will do a better job and a faster job than what a multi-tool can. However, there are those situations where you have to use a multi-tool, and this did a fine job. It was able to cut through all the nails that I threw at it, and it did okay, although I did destroy a blade or two. So just keep that in mind, that if your primary goal is to cut nails, consider another tool than a multi-tool. I just think it's a waste. And if you're wanting to cut screws, well, completely forget that with a multi-tool. Don't get me wrong, you can cut screws with a multi-tool. The problem is that you're going to be spending way too much money on each one of those blades, because it usually takes about a full blade to go through a screw, and it's just not worth it. Even if you're using a high quality blade, you might be able to get through a couple of screws, but in the long run, you would have been better off buying a reciprocating saw blade with carbide teeth used for cutting metal than a multi-tool blade used for cutting metal. It's just one of those things where you have to kind of look at the situation and think about what the actual price of this job is going to be. So in the long run, I would highly recommend not using multi-tools for cutting screws, but you can use them on the softer nails occasionally, but I still don't like doing that either. But in the end, if you choose to cut screws with a multi-tool, that's your own personal decision and your own money. However, if you do decide to go that route, would you also be interested in maybe buying this bridge I have for sale? It's called the Golden Gate Bridge, and it's a great bargain at only a couple $1,000s. If you're interested, please look for the information below. Okay, time to move on to the pros and cons. Well, maybe after what I just said, cons isn't the best thing to say right now. The pros and myths and that other thing. And the first pro is light. This is a very lightweight tool, meaning that it's very easy to hold over long periods of time. It will not get your arm tired, and overall, I'd have to say it's definitely a pro being so lightweight. Trigger. I really enjoy the fact that this multi-tool has a trigger. It's something I definitely was missing on the Makita, and the fact that this has it is definitely a pro. Onboard wrench. Now, this is kind of a caveat, because I really would have preferred having a quick blade change system, but because it doesn't, the fact that it has an onboard wrench is definitely a pro, and something I think a lot of tools other than this one should have incorporated into their design if that requires a wrench for changing the blades or discs or what have you. LED light. This is something else that was missing from the Makita that I really enjoy having, is an onboard LED light. When I first started using it, drills and impact drivers and things that had the LED lights, I got addicted to them fairly quickly, and it's something I think all tools should probably have incorporated into their design at some point, as long as they're incorporated smartly. Grip. Yes, I know this is something else that the Makita was lacking that I definitely would prefer having, and it's more of a preference, I guess. But for me personally, having the grip means that I can have more control over the tool, meaning that I can be more precise and be able to do a better job. So overall, definitely a pro. Oscillation width. Overall, I think the oscillation width on this Ryobi is definitely better than the Makitas. I think the Makitas is a little bit narrower, and I think the Ryobi's is a little bit wider. So I think the Ryobi does a better job at cutting through materials faster. So in my opinion, this is definitely a pro. Price. Now the price of this multi-tool is generally around $60, but it will go on sale and it'll drop down to around $50. And if you get in a kit, sometimes if you factor in the cost of the other tools, you can get even cheaper than that. So overall, it's a very affordable multi-tool at a great price. And if you want to get even cheaper over at Factory Direct, you can usually get the multi-tool for around $30 during some of their sales. You might have to wait until it goes on sale, but generally you can get fairly reasonably priced over there. So as long as you don't mind refurbished, that's another great way to go. So overall, it's a great multi-tool for a very good price. So I would definitely recommend it for those odd jobs that you might need a multi-tool for. And the first meh is brushed. Yes, it has an older motor in it, but at the same time, for the price point, you really can't complain. It'll still do a good job and it'll still last a long time as long as you take care of it. And the first climbing bad slash other is no quick blade change system. It would have been very nice if this had had a quick blade change system or a quick blade lever or something where you could take the blade off without the need of a tool, but it doesn't, and that's just kind of a disappointment. But like I said, at this price point, you really can't expect it, and it's still a good tool. It just takes a little bit longer to change the blades. And the last and biggest con would be the vibrations. Now the vibrations this little multi-tool put out are fairly intense on the highest setting. At the lower settings it's not very bad and it will handle those decently. But at level 6 this multi-tool will be vibrating at a high frequency. So I would highly recommend wearing gloves when using this multi-tool on high. Now, it's just the nature of multi-tools, and there's really no getting around it, especially at this price point. So just be aware if you do decide to purchase this tool and you're planning on using it at the highest settings. And that is it for the pros and cons. Final thoughts on this multi-tool. Overall, I've actually been very impressed by this little multi-tool. It fits great in the hand, and it'll be able to handle just about all the tasks that you can throw at it. I don't do much work with drywall, so I can't really comment on that, but for my own personal needs, it's done a fantastic job, and it's my current go-to multi-tool. I have been kind of curious about their brushless model because it has the quick blade change system, and that's really about the only thing it looks different, honestly, is the quick blade change system and the fact it's brushless. So I might try that in the future, but for now this little multi-tool has been doing a fantastic job, and I really do think it's a decent tool or a great tool depending on how you look at it. So in my opinion, I would highly recommend this to anybody who is currently in the need of a multi-tool and they don't mind going with Ryobi. So in my opinion, recommended. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And I really don't have a bridge to sell. That was a joke, so please don't take that seriously. And we'll see you next time. God bless.